And good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today I'm going to talk about the design for sustainability for super tall buildings. And sustainable design means a green design, and as a player in this industry, we really highlight that we focus on the green buildings in this industry.
现在我用一个简短的 PPT 来介绍一下绿色建筑的发展，以及在非常流行的两个评价标准，那就是第一的和中国绿色建筑评价标志。
And I'm going to spend a very brief presentation talking about the development of green buildings and the introduction to two certifications. One is LEED, the other one is the China Building Green Label.
最后我将介绍一下在苏州东南中心中使用到的可持续建筑设计。
And at the end of my presentation, I will share the sustainability design in Suzhou Zhongnan Tower. As you can see from this slide, these are the figures that buildings account for 72% of power consumption, 39% of energy use, 38% of our carbon dioxide emissions, and 14% of potable water consumption, and 40% of raw material use, and 30% of waste.
因而我们的绿色建筑集中也是为了解决这样的问题，全球关注的气候变化和资源损耗问题，水资源的消耗、生态系统的恶化、室内空气质量和租户的工作舒适度以及建筑的生活和工作经营成本。
And these are the issues and challenges that green buildings help to address: climate change, resource depletion, water consumption, degradation of ecosystem, indoor environment quality, occupant comfort and productivity, and cost of owning and operating work and living spaces.
然后作为一家绿建的咨询公司，我们也给成千上百的业主提供了绿色建筑方案，因为越来越多的业主也发现它从中存在的商业价值。
And as a consultant for green buildings, we have proposed plans for our clients because more and more clients has realized the commercial value of green buildings.
对，一个是运营成本得到很大的下降，建筑资产增值，投资回报增加，出租率增加和租金提高。
Because green buildings can help to reduce operating costs and increase building value, return on investment, and occupancy ratio and rent ratio.
现在国际和国内的大环境都是非常有利于绿色建筑的发展，这个就是一个国际上对于绿建的一个基本的一些目标和运用到的标准。And
the domestic and global environment is very good for the development of green buildings. These are the common targets and standards that are applied.
其中在目标这一块，大家一般都是制定的是对能耗的降低有一个目标，或者是碳排放的降低有一个目标。And
most of the targets are on the reduction of energy consumption and CO2 emission.
然后在评价标准方面，大家使用到的有 LEED Green，还有绿色建筑三星标准。
And as for the standards, most commonly used are LEED, BREEAM, and the Green Building Label.
国内的话也是一个很好的绿建发展的大形势。我们的国务院在05年的时候就已经提到了两个阶段的目标，这个也是从节能方面来说的。它的目标是2010年能够节能50%，然后2020年。
And also, like as I mentioned, in China, the environment is also very good because in 2005, the State Council has reformed these two-phase goals. By 2010, reduce energy consumption by 50%, and by 2020, 65%.
然后各个地方上也有强制性的建筑设计的目标。 而且现在有很多绿色建筑设计标准也出台了。根据这个设计标准的话，不仅仅是第三方在推进这个事情，就有很多建筑院或者说那个设计院，他们都会去把绿色建筑当成一个强制性的设计的目标来做。
And locally and regionally in China, there are many mandatory policies and regulations in terms of green building development as well. And we have new standards in the market, and mostly it's driven and pushed by third parties like design institutes and architecture.
好的，那接下来我介绍一下，目前比较适用的两个体系，一个是国际上通行的LEED，另外一个是中国绿色建筑设计标志。
And to move on, I'd like to talk about the two most common standards. One is LEED, the other one is China Green Building Label.
LEED 指的是能源与环境设计先锋的简介。
And as you can see, this is the definition of LEED.
对，它是由美国的一个USGBC机构进行推进的。
And it is also driven by an American organization.
LEED 被认为是指导绿色建筑设计施工和运行过程中最佳认证体系，因为它非常的现在来讲，它非常的普遍化，而且它有针对不同类型的建筑有不同的评价的适用体系，所以非常全面。
LEED is the most common and widely recognized and applied in the world, and LEED has different standards for different types of buildings.
LEED NC, LEED CS, LEED CI, LEED ND, LEED EB, LEED School, LEED Retail, and LEED Healthcare, LEED Homes, 这些是经常使用到的，前面三个的话是非常的多的使用。
As you can see, LEED for new construction, LEED for coal and shell, LEED for commercial interiors. These three are most common and widely used. Besides these three, we have LEED for neighborhood development, LEED for existing buildings, LEED for existing schools, retail, and healthcare.
LEED 它是一个评估体系，因为它主要是分为五个大的章节：节地、节水、能源和材料以及室内环境。 最下面两个，一个是创新，还有一个是地域优势的话，是根据前面的一些获得的能力更好的一些提高，能够得一些创新分。然后不同的全球不同的区域可以得到一些地域优势的奖。And
there are basically five major categories for scoring and evaluation from LEED, which are sustainable sites, water efficiency, energy and atmosphere, materials and resources, indoor environment and quality. As for the innovation design, the regional priority are based on the first five categories.
一个建筑根据它整个设计和施工下来，根据它能拿到的不同的分数，最后被认为可以得到认证级、银级或者金级和白金级。
And these are the different levels that a building can score for its construction and operating period.
那么在中国的话，现在用的比较多的一个评价标志是中国绿色建筑评价标志，也就是俗称绿标三星系统。The
China Green Label 3 Star System is also very commonly used in China.
这样一个系统，它其实也借鉴了很多LEED的优势，但是它在里面的得分点里面可能是根据中国的一些大陆的一些现状，会有一些修改。 而且最大的不同是它这些每一个章节它有不同的权重。And
this system borrows the concept and the architecture from LEED, and it also considers the characteristics and special situation here in China.
其中在节能和能源利用这个章节依然是最高权重的，因为它是分为0.28分，所有的权重加在一起是1分嘛，然后节能这一块是最重要的。
And what is special of the China Label 3 star system is each category was given different weights, and the energy saving was given 28% weight, which is the highest.
对，然后它的认证有也是
And different from LEED, the China Green Label 3 star system has 3 levels, which are 1, 2, and 3 stars respectively.
一开始就有一个提高，因为一星级传统意义来讲是对于LiJun的理念的引起的，就是说它已经没有认证级这个概念了。And one star is equal to the silver level of LiJun. 绿色建筑评价指标，这样，而且不同的地方它有一个节能的补贴，就如果拿到绿建的认证以后，可以去申报相关的补贴，就要看地方上不同地方上的那个要求不一样，所以越来越多的业主愿意去做这个绿建的认证。
And this is a national system. And apart from this, in different regions, there are local systems applied as well. And local government and authorities would subsidize for the buildings who have achieved that a 3-star level from this green system.
它跟绿的也是相似，最后能够获得一个国家环保部颁发的一个证书。
And just like these, the buildings will receive a certificate from the Environmental Protection Ministry of
China.
And let's look at the sustainability design in this project, Zhongnan Tower. And this is a super tall building with more than 700 meters height, and it has very diverse function zones. So after all, it's a very complicated building.
中南集团也比较重视绿建这一块吧，所以对绿标刚开始的定位就非常高，比如说获得LEED的金级以及绿标三星级。And
our client Zhongnan Group attached great importance to the sustainability of its building, so the goal was set very high as a LEED Gold certification and China Green Building Label 3 star.
然后这是因为这样有一个很高的定位，以及这个项目自身的复杂程度，所以对于我们获得这个标志，确实是有很大的难度和挑战。And
because of the complexity of the building itself and the high goals that were set by the client, so it is very challenging for us.
然后我们作为他们的顾问方，我们在建筑的初期就已经摄入进去，然后是根据LEED以及绿标得分点的要求。 给他们不同的专业，包括建筑、然后给排水结构、电气、景观和装修，提供一些建议。And
as the partner, we enter discussion and communication with our clients from a very early stage, from the preliminary design stage, and we have given them advice and recommendations based on the categories of LEED and China Green Label System.
对，然后这一块我们主要是在这个演讲中，我不是按照那个专业来分的，是主要是分了几个大块，就是能源，还有水，还有一些其他的那个地下室采光和风环境设计等等，来稍微介绍一下。Then
I will share some of the details with you from different aspects.
对，然后这个能源设计这一块，可能后续我们的项目是有一些改变的，有些系统上的改变，这个是早期做的一些想法的 PPT， 所以会有一些出入下面。And
in this presentation, in this energy design part, this is our initial ideas. There might be some changes and adjustments along with the time.
我们能源设计总的方案总的给他们的一个思路就是希望在需求端减少能源的消耗，需求好消耗，以及冷热源对他们有一个优化性的建议，还有 希望他们做那个可再生能源，因为这些在低的或者说绿标三星中都有相应的得分点。
And for energy design, for these aspects, we give them three, basically three focuses. The first one is to reduce the demand of energy and to optimize the heat and cooling source and to use renewable energy.
第一个是减少需求，减少需求这里的话，我们当时这个国标它还没有对超高层有一个很细致的要求，所以当时借鉴的这个标准是超高层建筑评价技术细则，也就是那个上海中心他们那个借鉴的标准，所以就根据这个来进行一个评价的。然后 B 的这一块是相应的，也有一个目标值。
And for the reduction of demand of energy, we were looking and the suggestion were based on the evaluation of technical rules of super high-rise green buildings in China, which is also the basis of the Shanghai Center Tower, because the national standard didn't have specific requirements and codes in this regard.
在定了一些指标上的目标以后，我们是根据拿到建筑方他们的一个初步的设计方案，我们会做模拟能耗模拟，然后做完能耗模拟以后，我们对他们那个幕墙上面有一些优化性的那个建议系数在这边。
And after getting the preliminary design from the Design Institute, we have done some simulation of energy consumption, and based on that simulation, we have given them results to recommend, which is on the right hand side of the slide.
对，如果做到这个的话，就是相当于维护结构这边已经符合了上前面的那些目标值。
And if they can follow these numbers, they can achieve the targets that we set.
第二个方面是冷热源的设计。
Second part is heat and cooling source.
对，冷热源的设计这里呢，当时我们的项目是希望能够做那个冰蓄冷的，因为这是一个超高层的建筑嘛，它的空调供值需求非常之大，所以根据做一个冰蓄冷的话，能够很好的利用那个可以风谷上面差，根据风谷差异的不同，然后把能源得到很好利用，减少那个电力方面的消耗。
So basically in this regard, we suggest ice storage, which can help to balance the demand between daytime and nighttime in different seasons.
因为我们做绿标的时候也是有一些特殊情况，因为我们隔壁的建筑他们也是做这个的话，是国家要求他们一定要这样去做，然后我们也要申请绿标的话，也被要求一定要这样去做。后来这个的话，根据苏州地区它的风谷电价并没有那么大，然后这一条的话也相应的现在已经削弱了，而且我们向那个绿标的一些评审机构也申请到，就是说我们这一条可以先不参评。
And this was basically the mandatory requirements by the authority for the building that was next to the Suzhou Zhongnan Center. But the reality, the situation in Suzhou is the difference of the electricity price and the peak time and the non-peak time are not that big. So we have also requested for the authority of the green label that this will not be one of the criteria that for our evaluation.
然后可再生能源就是用了那个用在群房上面铺设了一些太阳能发电板，用作机电设备的一些他供给他们能源。这个我们是协同 PD 这边，就是说帮助，就是跟他们一起去探讨一些方案吧。
And for renewable energy, we have installed solar panels on the roof of the podium.
对，我们这个项目后面是就是说现在也是用那个市镇上的余热废热做那个能源的补充，这一块可以填补冰蓄冷没做冰蓄冷带来的那个损耗。
And we also recycle waste heat, which will complement the loss of the ice storage system.
然后下一个是再生水的设计，就是中水雨水这一块的东西。
And this is for renewable water, includes grey water and rain water collection.
水这一块的话， 整个绿标体系评价下来，就是根据 LEED 和绿界三星，我们水基本上是拿了满分，或者说比满分少一点点分，就是所以这块要求非常之高，对系统 的要求也非常高。
In terms of this water reuse, we achieved almost perfect score by LEED evaluation and the China Green Label 3-star system.
我们建议就是做雨水收集，然后能够全场地的雨水收集来控制年净流量总量低于70%，收集到的雨水包括说有一些冷凝水用作那个冷却塔的补水和空水井的补水。
And for the rainwater collection system, we suggest that sediment water to be collected and no less than 70% of the total annual runoff and be reused in cooling tower water as well.
在中水方面的话，我们是收集办公区域的杂排水来供给地道路地库冲洗和室外绿化灌溉和洗车用水。
And for the recycle of grey water, we collect drainage water from the office area and treat the water and reuse in road and underground flushing, landscape irrigation, car washing.
就是这个的话，我们也是经过绿标这边的一些计算，然后跟 PD 这边也是协同去给到他们一定的建议。然后生化的方面还是 PD 这边在做。
And we also worked with the PB to further develop the plan and solution for the client.
接下来就是有一些其他的东西，包括像地下室采光。地下室采光的话，我们这个项目有下沉式广场，然后我们也是对地下室的采光进行了采光模拟。现在目前的设计方案能够实现它的有效采光能够达到地下室一层面积的22%。
And there are three plazas in this project, and based on our simulation, we can reach 22% of total the lighting of basement, the first level of the basement on the three plazas.
这个22%是一个非常高的值，因为在绿标里面20%的话，它就已经拿到一个满分了。一般的项目只能做到10%、15%，所以22%的话也是一个很大的亮点。
And 22% is a very high number in the system because 20% is already the perfect score in the green label system. And normal buildings here in China can only achieve 10-15%.
接下来是那个场地风环境的设计，其实就是我们根据早期建筑师这边的一些方案来做那个 CFD 的模拟嘛，然后得到。就是经过我们的模拟结果是能够实现在绿标里面有要求必须在人行区1.5米高处风速低于5米每秒才是一个很好的场地风环境，最后我们的项目能够达到这个要求。
And based on the CFD simulation, we have designed the sampling environments and up and meet the requirements from the green label system, which is the wind speed less than 5 meters per second within 1.5 meters high around the building. Thank you very much. That's all for the presentation.